Welcome to Prior Lake Student News Spring 1987 broadcast. I'm Janine Bonsack, and reporting with me is Kirby Morley.
Vandalism and robbery strikes a Prior Lake senior high, and $1,500 worth of computer goods are stolen. Jerry Will, one of the janitors in the senior high, was making his rounds on Sunday, May 9th, when he noticed a door was open in the 100 hallway. The janitors make rounds to check for vandalism and robbery, and for break-ins. Jerry said it was about 9:45 a.m. when he was making his rounds, and he saw the door open. He went in to check the room. The classrooms are all supposed to be locked, especially when teachers aren't around. As Jerry walked into the room, it was obvious there was some disturbance. A rock was thrown through the window, which is how the classroom was entered. Immediately after entering the room, Jerry contacted the police and Mr. Blaisdell. The room was closed and no one was allowed to enter until the police furthered their investigation. When talking to other students and staff, they all agree whoever took what they took knew what they were doing. The police later searched and took fingerprints of the room. According to the police report, a disk drive and a computer keyboard were taken. When talking to Ms. Oldenwald, the special ed teacher, where the computer was taken from, Ms. Oldenwald said, "I find it strange that they took what they did and left the computer monitor. All the Prior Lake computer equipment is marked, so this will make it easier in locating the equipment."
On May 2nd, a statewide convention was held honoring the outstanding journalists of high school newspapers. Held at the University of Minnesota, judges for the event were representatives of the Minnesota High School Press Association. Of the entries submitted by newspaper advisor Lynn Kaler, bringing home a first place award in the sports writing category was the Laker Times' Jeff Bennett. Bennett was the sole winner from Prior Lake. His award-winning article was, "Why Prior Lake Doesn't Win." Congratulations, Jeff.
On Monday, May 18th, the 1987-88 Student Council class officers and representatives were elected at the Student Council banquet. This year, the new voting registration system was used, and Ms. Keekley said it worked pretty well. The Student Council is now traveling to the junior high and to St. Mike's to get freshman council members for next year. The following were elected student council officers for the 87-88 year: President Michelle Gans, Vice President Sarah Case, Treasurer Lee Pomerleau, and Secretary Nikki Foster. Representatives were also elected for the junior, sophomore, and senior classes.
A plan giving the high school land to use as an environmental study area is going to go before the school board sometime this summer. Andrew Franklin, a science teacher at Prior Lake Senior High, is heading up the plan to obtain the study area. The proposed site is a field across the street from the main entrance of the school. Franklin is hoping to have enough land set aside to allow science and other outdoor-related classes some room to function in a realistic outdoor environment. The amount of land proposed has not yet been officially determined, but Franklin is hoping to have about 10 acres granted. The action was taken by Franklin because he wanted to clean up the area and keep it in a natural state for both animals and men to enjoy, not abuse. The area as of now is being used as a dumping site for school materials. Franklin's ecology class has recently been working to clean up the mess by hauling away debris and terracing areas of land in order to reduce erosion and create new plant and animal growth. All classes which need an outdoor setting will be able to use the study area. Franklin hopes to have the study area open for the 1987-88 school year.
On May 17th, the Prior Lake Band marched in the annual Sutton Dare My Parade in Minneapolis and won first place for marching units. The parade was organized by a group called the Sons of Norway, who were formed to preserve and protect their Norwegian heritage. The reason for the parade was to celebrate the signing of Norway's constitution, which is much like our 4th of July celebration. Along with Prior Lake Band, there were six other marching bands. Prior Lake was placed 11th position, which is very close to the beginning of the parade. The parade started at Minneapolis Auditorium and went until they got to the IDS Center. There, the judges gave each band and each section a review. After that, the band continued on until they got back to the Minneapolis Auditorium, where the parade was finished. On Monday, after the parade, the the parade organizer called Mr. Zeman to tell him the good news that Prior Lake had won first place in the marching band category.
The Institute of Arts is one of the leading museums in the United States. On Tuesday, May 19th, the humanities classes visited the Institute. The Institute provides a wide variety of art, ranging from a 2,000-year-old mummy to a view of contemporary photography. The museum's collection of more than 70,000 objects boasts a large number of works recognized throughout the world as masterpieces. The newest acquisition at the Institute at a cost of $2.5 million was a sculpture of the incredible athlete, Theodore Forrest.
And now here's Brett Woodson with some sports.
In the NBA last night, Detroit rallied to defeat Boston, tie the series at 3, and send it into Game 7 at the Boston Garden. In the NHL, Philadelphia knocked off Edmonton after coming back from a 2-goal deficit to tie that series at 3 and also send it into Game 7. In local sports, the past year, two head coaches resigned from Prior Lake this year, the football coach Bill Hansen and the hockey coach Daryl Barlage. The school recently decided who the replacements would be. John Bennett will be the football coach. He currently is teaching biology at Holy Angels Academy. Next year, he will be teaching physical education both at the junior high and at the high school. John's goals for next season are to have a winning season and to improve the program. The new hockey coach is also from Holy Angels. He is John Wilson. John will be teaching industrial arts at the high school next year. Last year, Coach Wilson led his team to their best season ever. He hopes to have the same success at Prior Lake this year. His goals for next season are to compete great in the Minnesota Conference and to do good in the sectional playoffs. In synchronized swimming, the girls are preparing for the state tournament, which is going on right now. On May 7th, the Lakers met Simley and Edina in the pool. The Lakers outswam the Spartans 35-5 and showed improvement in their 26-17 loss to Edina. The Hornets are becoming a grudge match for Lakers as they aim a team of Kim Anderson, Heather Clausen, Debbie Ellingson, Nancy Gwynn, Michelle Nordstrom, Danelle Pickett, Wendy Scheidt, and Patty Spindler came up short against Edina. In solo competition, Nancy Gwynn placed third, and in the duets, Kim Anderson, Danelle Pickett also placed third against Edina. In their overwhelming win against Simley, Leanne Taylor placed first in solos, and Ann Cameron and Chris Stark took first place in duets, followed closely by the duet of Carrie Davis and Annie Grove, who placed second. In the trio department, the Lakers also managed the first two spots. Heather Clausen, Nancy Gwynn, and Patty Spindler came in first, while Danelle Pickett, Michelle Nordstrom, and Wendy Scheidt came in second. Another first-place finish was recorded by a seven-member group of Lisa Hoff, Lori Holter, Michelle Huber, Sharon Matuza, Kelly Noner, Leanne Taylor, and Michelle Zacher. On May 12th, the Lakers ran up against a tough Stillwater squad, losing 30-12. Nancy Gwynn managed a second-place finish in her solo swim. After their Dolphin show on May 22nd and 23rd, the Lakers will be competing in their state competition. On March 7th, the Prior Lake boys track team had their captains meet against Park Center and Hastings. This is a meet where the captains choose who participates in each event. Everyone did four events regardless of what they did before. Needless to say, the boys track team lost by a score of Park Center 87, Hastings 78, and Prior Lake 27. Have fun, Coach Hollenbeck said before they got off the bus, and that's exactly what they did. With 12 people doing the long jump, 9 people doing the shot, and 10 people doing the disc, officials at Hastings weren't happy at all. One of the Prior Lake tracksters that threw the shot and disc was 120-pounder John Schricker. John threw the shot 21 feet, 2 inches, and 56-something in the disc. The 4x100 relays, which consists of Tim Mannion, Sam Warrington, Joe Brahm, and Tony Raymer, and the 4x200 relays, which consists of Mike Peterson, Tony Raymer, Tim Mannion, and John Schmidt, were the only events Prior Lake took first in. But other outstanding achievements were accomplished. Sam Warrington, a junior long jumper, jumped 19 feet 5 inches to capture a second place. Scott Pee Wee Pierce, an eighth grader, also placed second in the mile. In baseball, after dropping game one of round two of the Minnesota Conference race to the Red Knights of Vinyl St. Margaret's by the score of 9-7, the Laker baseball team launched a 9-game winning streak to end the regular season play with a 15-3 record. Highlighting the streak was a first place finish in the annual Centennial Tournament, where 7 teams tried to knock off the Lakers as reigning champions. Lakers dominated play right from the bat by defeating River Falls, Wisconsin 11-0, behind heavy hitting of Jeff Hacksaw Carlson, who homered to cap it all off. In the semifinal game against Spring Lake Park, the Lakers scored 6 runs only to see their lead dwindle to 1 run. The Lakers pulled away when Bruce Hymer launched a 380-foot home run to boost the team to another rally and win the game 9-7. In the championship game, the host team of Centennial, the Lakers found themselves down 6-1 when they found their true colors with a 5-run rally capped off by a 3-run homer by Brett Brusky. Senior Paul Kearney led off the next inning with a 370-foot blast over the left field wall to tie the game, and Brett Brusky hit his second home run of the game, leading the Lakers to a 9-7 win for the trophy. Big wins over New Prague, Red Wings, Simley, and Lakeville led the Lakers to the final game against Holy Angels, where they beat the 4th-ranked Co-Stars 7-4, behind strong pitching of starter Steve Strongbones Hagelin and reliever Brian Big Murray. Hagelin and reliever Brian Murray, the Lakers got out of their jam. Senior Paul Kearney and Kevin Schultz each had a home run as they combined for 5 hits and 5 RBIs to lead the Lakers 6. Congratulations are due to Mr. Busselman and his squad for a fine 15-win regular season. This spring, there has been a numerous amount of sports injuries. In baseball, Terry Iverson left the season 3/4 of the way through when he broke his hand in an alumni game. Bill Gabler was also injured this season when he severely sprained his ankle while running to first base in a Centennial tournament game. Bill missed about 3 games and is now ready to compete in the playoffs. Boys track has also suffered several injuries. Here's a list of a few of them. John Schmidt, a hairline fracture in the ankle. Todd Hofferman, pulled muscle. Eric Bull, pulled groin and sutures in the knee. Joe Brahma, pulled muscle. Tim Matheson, stress fracture. Most of these athletes are trying to recover, and John Schmidt, out of these athletes, is the only one going to regionals, but he is expected to be at 100%. Another sport which is usually injury-free is synchronized swimming. However, this year is unfortunately different. Cindy Leidner dislocated her shoulder while practicing. She is expected to be out for the season. Softball, girls track, boys golf, and girls golf have all managed to be relatively healthy. Speaking of girls golf, Maggie Henson qualified for the state golf meet scheduled for June 3rd when she plays 4th in the regional competition. And that wraps up the sports.
Parking fee update. The question of will the rate remain the same or will it be prorated has been for the most part concluded. The student council met and felt it will remain the same as it was this year at the cost of $15 to park for the entire year, regardless of when it is purchased.
Prizes, fun, food, and games is how co-chairperson Charles Hall describes the senior lock-in. Betsy, Jader, and Hall are in charge along with the help of many senior parents. Prizes were donated, and some were purchased with funds donated by the parents. Some of the prizes include a computer, telephones, television, luggage, compact disc players, stereos, and much more.
On Tuesday, May 12th, the NHS held its annual awards banquet. The banquet for the awards presented. Treasurer Debbie Elling started off the evening with an introduction and welcome. Secretary Steve Blakeborough and historian Michelle Frank followed with a recap of the highlights year. Then each senior was recognized and given a rose. Ms. Mahachik, who has been named the Academic Advisor of the Year and who will also be the advisor for the MAHS State Advisor for next year, awarded the Leadership Award to President T.J. Thaldorf and Vice President Suzanne Balow. The Most Active Award was also given to Sue Balow. At the end of the awards presentation, the 1987-88 officers were named. They are as follows: President John Clausen, Vice President Jeff Frank, Secretary Tammy Hoyer, and Historian Lisa Hoff.
On May 12th and 13th, juniors voted for next year's senior class officers. When all the ballots were counted, Brett Woodson remained the president for another year. The wide-open race for vice president was taken by John Schmidt. Mark Jenkins entered the running late, but still came up with enough votes to win the secretary position. The treasurer spot was filled by Stacy Sousa. There are 3 parties running for social directors: Allison Ilstrup and Chris Leno, James Kemp and Brian Daines, and Mark Schneider. Ilstrup and Leno were the winners. The senior class officers' main jobs are prom and graduation. We would like to have grand march around 5 o'clock at the school, with the dance starting at 8 in an area hotel, explains Vice President Schmidt as the plans for the 1988 prom begin.
This year's graduation commencement is scheduled for June 5th, beginning at 7:30 p.m. The ceremonies will be held outside on Laker Field, weather permitting. The class of 87 chose peach and ivory for their class colors. Lean on Me was voted class song. The class motto is as follows: how high our hearts can reach, how far our thoughts can take us, how full our days can be, how free our dreams can make us. School board members will be handing out diplomas. Along with Superintendent Dr. Cy Cruzy and Senior High School Principal Fred Blaisdell. Student speakers at the ceremony are to be Michelle Frank and Paul Keel. Immediately following the graduation, most seniors will be attending Mardi Gras, the all-night lock-in party.
Every year when the weather warms up and the sun is high and school is getting closer to being done, a worry sickness comes over the senior class. What is the sickness? It's called senioritis. Senioritis hits most of the seniors at our school. It comes on for some as soon as spring comes on, and it doesn't go away until school is out. Senioritis can affect both the mind, the body, or both. When senioritis affects the body, the seniors feel a craving for sun and a deep, dark tan. Seniors can't, however, achieve this after school hours unless they go to an electric beach, so the seniors skip some day of school every now and then to achieve getting a tan. When seniors stop turning in homework or are not paying attention in class, it is also known as senioritis, but this is where it affects the mind. Seniors usually get this when they are busy thinking about summer or planning their graduation parties. If you see a senior walking in a daze or with a good tan, just remember that this person probably has senioritis, and be careful because it's contagious.
Don't I know it? The time is drawing near now to say a sweet goodbye to the people we've been friends with since we were just knee-high. Another year has rolled by, and from Prior Lake Senior High, another senior class is graduating. Taking the major part of 13 years, it seems the whole class is getting along as one. We have had the cliques and the groupies, the outcasts, and all the others, but getting right down to the line, we are all one big happy bunch of friends. It's not over yet. There are still 5 days left of laughing and kidding in the halls. A lot more to look forward to, like senior lock-in after commencement, and then graduation parties, and finally friends getting together out on the lake and in town. With just 2 weeks left, there is a ring in the halls, and of all the old times and fun times, and comparisons of stories and memories being made. Still, there is a lot to look forward to. New schools, new jobs, new friends, and new careers. This is Kirby Morlock.
And I'm Janine Polachek. Thank you for joining us.